Getting great sleep is vital to your everyday performance, and vitally important to your sleep is your evening routine. And there are two key pillars to your evening routine. It's number one, the environment in which you are sleeping in, setting that up for a great night of sleep. And then secondly, the routine itself. And in this video, I'm going to break down exactly what you should be doing before you go to sleep so you get great sleep, so you don't wake up throughout the night, and so you don't have trouble falling asleep. And that's what we're going to cover right now. Hi, and welcome back to the Conscious Leaders TV. I'm Yannick Ratzner, I'm your leadership coach, and here in this video, we're going to break down the two key pillars to a great evening routine. And we all know that great sleep is vitally important to how we feel and how we perform each and every day. And great sleep starts with a strong, powerful evening routine that primes you to fall asleep fast, to get deep sleep, and to don't wake up throughout the night. So let's talk about those two key pillars. Number one is your environment. I mean, the environment that you're sleeping in has a vital aspect to how you're sleeping. So here's what you'll need to do. Make sure that the room that you're sleeping in is dark. I mean, especially if you're living in regions where in the evening it's still very like bright outside, you want to darken out the room and you want to remove all technical devices like your TV, your smartphone, your tablet. You want to remove all of them from your bedroom because the blue light from the light, from the sunlight and from your devices, it is suppressing melatonin, and melatonin is designed to make you sleepy. So if you suppress melatonin, no wonder you're having trouble going to sleep simply because you've been signaling your body that it's not time to sleep. So it's really vitally important to darken out the room and to remove all devices from your sleep environment, from your bedroom. And also, like those devices, it's vitally important that you really turn them off or you put them in airplane mode so throughout the night you're not disturbed by notifications or phone calls or anything like that, because that is going to kill your sleep quality. So that's really vitally important. And secondly, you want to sleep in a room that is a little bit cold. And you want to have some fresh air in the room. And maybe some plants even help. So that's what you want to do for the environment that you're sleeping in. So what you want to make sure, no devices, dark room, cold room, fresh air, and then you're already set. And then let's go over to the routine. And that has also something to do with your devices. 1 hour before you go to sleep, you want to make sure that you don't look at any devices. Because again, that blue light, it is going to block melatonin. And if you're blocking melatonin, you're having trouble falling asleep. So you want to remove all devices 1 hour before you go to bed. Then second key practice is do something for yourself. Maybe have a massage, a hot bath, do some meditation, some journaling. Something for you, something that makes you feel relaxed, something that disconnects you from your work, which makes a clean cut like in the hour before you go to sleep. So that is critically important. Do something for yourself and to connect to others. That's really vitally important. You want to do something that fuels your joy, that fuels your happiness, that makes you feel relaxed. So that is vitally important. And by the way, if you like this video so far, then smash that like button, subscribe right here, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. And then the next thing I recommend you do is fasting. I mean, 3 hours approximately before you go to sleep, have your last meal. Afterwards, don't eat anything because you're giving your body enough time to digest, so it's easier to fall asleep and have a great night of sleep. So that is really vitally important. But of course, don't go to bed like starving to death, because then you're also having a hard time to fall asleep, and then you're going to wake up throughout the night simply because your body feels like, well, I need something to eat, I need energy. So you need to make sure that those 3 hours before you go to sleep, you have a nice meal that fuels you, to the morning, like until the morning. So that's really critically important. And then a simple practice that I recommend you do every single evening. It is so simple, you're going to laugh, but it is going to change your life. It's simply called deliberate gratitude. Deliberate gratitude. Here's what you want to do. Each evening before you fall asleep, think of three things that you are grateful for, and then feel those emotions just for like the previous day. What was great about this day? What did I like? And you want to do this especially on the days which were not great, because you're retraining, you're rewiring your emotional architecture, and you're like training yourself into positive thinking. Because as you think about the positive, as you fall asleep, now you're holding those thoughts and those emotions in your mind and in your heart. When you wake up, you feel different. I know. When I do this in the evening before I go to sleep, I sleep so much better. I just feel differently. So I highly recommend that you try deliberate gratitude. Just try it for 2 weeks every single evening and see how it changes your sleep and how you feel and how you think. I highly recommend that you do. And if you want to go so much deeper in how to get great sleep, then I highly recommend that you watch this video next. It will change your sleep forever. And then until the next time, make sure that you live fully, live openly, and be the leader of your life.